Hey guys, this is Vikas here and this is We Are Genius. Guys, today I'm with a build tutorial where we are going to make a best of power supply out of one old SMPS, which obviously is of desktop, right? So best of power supply is pretty much required whenever you are going to work with like embedded system or electronics projects, where we need multiple voltage supplies, right? Like 3.3 volt, 5 volt, 12 volt, etc. So instead of going to buy one ready-made or best of power supply, we can just convert our old SPS laying around into a best of power supply. And advantage of using it is it can supply up to 20 amps of current, and that is actually at a much cheaper cost than buying one from the market. So let's check it out, guys. Let's do it. So guys, this is one of my old SMPS and I was having this in one of my old PC. Let's open it up and just be careful about one thing. Whenever you are opening your SMPS, you are voiding the warranty. So keep it in mind. Let's open it. Okay, keep it aside. So over here you can see the exhaust fan over here, the PC board and the input and bunch of cables. So just remove it, we don't need it anymore. Now open up the circuit board from the chassis. So over here you can see this is the AC input and these are the output cables. So let's cut the unwanted wires from here. Just keep one from each group. Let's cut these things. So guys, I have cut the undesired cables. You can just remove these cut pieces by using a soldering iron. So we are just left with this much of wires. So the orange one stands for 3.3 volt. The red one stands for plus 5 volt. The black stands for ground. Yellow stands for plus 12 volt. The green, when sorted with ground, makes the SMPS switch on. Just you can check out, the fan will start to rotate. The blue stands for minus 12 volt. Purple stands for it supplies you the standby voltage. So even if your SMPS is not switched on, it'll get some voltage that is enough to drive some indicators so that you can know like my SMPS is getting powered, right? And the gray stands for like your power on wire. So like it gives you certain voltage to drive LEDs and all, so that you can just know your SMPS has got switched on. So let's check it out. So let's grab a power cable and just I have plugged it into the SMPS and just let's peel up some wires. Yeah, one note guys, with some SMPS you might need a 10 ohm 10 watt resistor between the 5 volt and ground. That is to show the SMPS that I have connected my motherboard to the SMPS. Otherwise some SMPS it might not turn on. So you can see the voltage between the purple wire and ground is around 5.5 volt. That is the standby voltage. So even if your SMPS is not switched on, you can just connect any LED and other devices which can run without turning on the SMPS. Even if the SMPS is switched off, you'll get certain supply over here. So to turn on the SMPS, let's short the green wire with the ground. So you can see when the two green wire and the ground is shorted, the fan of the SMPS is just like rotating. So the SMPS is got switched on and we can just verify the voltages around the different wires. Oh sorry, they just got separated. So like okay, let's first check for the power on cable, that is the gray one, and you can see I am getting around 5 volt. That means my SMPS is switched on. Purple wire same 5 volt, my SMPS is getting powered. Red wire, this is the 5 volt supply because I don't have any load right now, it's showing me 6 volt. The blue wire, that corresponds to minus 12 volt. So as I have no load onto the SMPS, you can see higher ratings over here. The yellow wire, this stands for 12 volt. And lastly the orange wire, that stands for 3.3 volt. So guys, I have left the wires open and I just tested out like my voltages are okay, I'm able to switch on my SMPS. So you can just connect with some headers to these wires and one switch and two LEDs, so that you'll have indication, power supply output, as well as switch to turn it on and off. And the switch has to be put between the green wire and the black wire, that is the power on cable and ground, and you can just put independent headers for each voltages. So I'm not going to show that. That's all guys, thank you. Hey, it's me once again, and hope you have liked the video and it might come useful in your project, and actually it can be used with any electronic devices that is requiring the voltage supplied by the SMPS. For me, I am doing a couple of SMPS modified for my home automation system. That is, I am using with Arduino and Raspberry Pi. Don't forget to subscribe to get the latest content. Thank you guys. Thanks for watching.